harmless-looking ball is actually one of the most dangerous of all weapons. It is called a mine, and it explodes when it is touched.
Boy, do I love walnuts.
During the American Civil War, mines were called torpedoes, and they played an historic part in one of the most exciting sea stories of all time.
I know what he's talking about. I was there, Mobile, Alabama, with Admiral David Glasgow Farragut. Say, you know, this thing looks just like one of those exploding torpedoes.
The job of the Northern Navy in the Civil War was to stop all supplies from reaching the Southern armies in the field. When it became necessary to capture a major seaport, which was being used to receive these supplies, the job was given to David Glasgow Farragut. Believe it or not, Farragut had commanded a ship when he was just 12 years old. Now, in his 60s, the Navy was his whole life. His first important assignment was to capture the number one seaport of the South, New Orleans. He was given mortar ships, which blasted at the forts which guarded the city. But the forts still stood. So Farragut made up his own daring plan on the spot. Under cover of darkness, he and his 17 ships made a breathtaking dash up the river right under the muzzles of the fort's cannon. In one brilliant stroke, New Orleans had been cut off from its defenses. Farragut was promoted to senior rear admiral, and his greatest glory still was ahead of him, the city of Mobile, Alabama.
I wanted to go with them to Mobile because they have pecan nuts there, and I like pecan nuts even better than walnuts. But boy, were they protecting their pecans.
Mobile was guarded by several forts, a long string of mines, and the heavy ironclad warship, the Tennessee. In order to enter the city, Farragut would first have to get by the Tennessee. He pleaded with the Navy to give him several small ironclad ships called monitors, after the very first northern ironclad, which battled the Merrimack several years before. With the monitors, he could battle the Tennessee. After that, he would see. On August 5th, 1864, Farragut entered Mobile Bay in two columns, the monitors leading and his wooden ships following. Farragut stood on the quarterdeck of his flagship Hartford and watched and waited as his leading monitor, the Tecumseh, headed for battle with the great
Day 30, here on 2 and 7, Calgary Television.